Hello students, this is our chapter number 6, Cell, the Fundamental Unit of Life. Let us recapitulate a few important points. Robert Hooke in 1965 observed the cell in the slices of a cork, and he used a simple magnifying device, and when he noticed some boxes or compartments in the cork slices. He termed these boxes as cells. Actually, the cork cells were the dead cells. They were not living cells. The number of cells. Living organisms are classified into unicellular and multicellular organisms based on the number of cells. Now, the organisms which are made up of only single cell are called unicellular. Examples are amoeba and paramecium. The organisms made up of more than one cell are called multicellular organisms. All the other organisms, including us human beings, we all are multicellular. Some important points that we need to know is that all the life begins with a single cell, and that is the fertilized egg, which later on multiplies and forms a zygote and later on develops a full formed organism. The size of cell may vary. It may be very, very minute, from some micrometers in some bacteria to some almost good visible size of eggs, which are very well, very much visible with the help of naked eyes. Now, the size of cell, important point, that the size of cell is not related with the size of organism. It is rather related to the function. You can see the various slides, the various shapes and size of cells here. Now, this is the diagram of a simple animal cell, basically, in which you can see all the different cell organelles. And here, after this, we are going to learn about the different cell organelles. First and foremost, the cell membrane. Cell membrane is the basic membrane of any cell. The presence of cell membrane is a must for a cell to exist. There is no cell which is present without a cell membrane, be it plant cell or animal cell or any other cell. Now, it is the outermost covering in the animal cell, but in a plant cell, it is covered with another layer which is known as cell wall. Now, cell membrane is semi-permeable, as we all know, which allows or permits the exchange of oxygen, carbon dioxide and various nutrients across it along with water. Cell wall, it is present only in the plant cell, as we all know. The basic function is to protect and give shape to the cell, and it is made up of cellulose. Cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the matter inside the cell membrane in which all the cell organelles are nucleus. Nucleus is also known as the brain of the cell. It controls all the activities of the cells. It gives instructions, just like our brain, to whatever activities are being done or conducted in the cell. Now these instructions are found on a hereditary material called DNA. Nuclear membrane, as the name suggests, it is the membrane which covers the nucleus. It is present in a eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cells do not have a nuclear membrane. The basic function is it separates nucleus from the cytoplasm, and again, just like the cell membrane, it also controls the movement of materials in and out of the nucleus. Nucleolus, it is a small cell organelle present within the nucleus. Now, prokaryotic cells, as we all know, prokaryotic cells are the cells which do not have a nuclear membrane. That is, the nucleus as such is not present. It is rather called nucleoid. The central area where the nucleic material is present is known as nucleoid. Eukaryotic cells are the cells marked by the presence of a nuclear membrane around the nucleus. It also contains membrane bound cell organelles. Here are the few differences between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. As you can easily see, the number of ribosomes 70s and 80s, the type of ribosomes are the, then cell wall, and then cell organelles, genetic material, size, and the number of usually single strand DNA, double strand DNA. Diagram, you can easily see the diagrams also. Now mitochondria. Mitochondria is known as the powerhouse of the cell. It is because it produces energy in the form of ATP. It is basically the site of respiration. It is a double layered structure, just like the nucleus. It contains its own DNA also. Endoplasmic reticulum. It is a series of folded membranes that move materials within the cell. The main function of endoplasmic reticulum is transportation. In smooth endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes are not attached, but rough endoplasmic reticulums, here the ribosomes, as the name suggests, ribosomes are attached on the surface of it, the endoplasmic reticulum. Golgi bodies are again stacked flattened membranes. They sort and package materials for transportation. Lysosomes, known as the suicidal bags of the cell. Why? Because they kill the cells, they digest their own cell in case of some deformity or malfunctioning of the cell. And how they do it? They release certain strong digestive enzymes which digest their own cell. Ribosomes are related to protein synthesis. They either float freely or are found attached to the rough endoplasmic reticulum. This is how the lysosomes work. क्रोमैटिन इज द बेसिक जेनेटिक मटीरियल, जेनेटिक कोड विच कंट्रोल्स ऑल द फंक्शंस ऑफ द सेल. इट इज मेड अप ऑफ डीएनए प्रोटीन्स. वैक्यूल्स, वैक्यूल्स आर मेजरली स्टोरेज ऑर्गन्स, स्टोरेज स्पेसेस विच स्टोर फूड, वाटर एंड वेस्ट. This is the diagram of vacuole as you can see. In plant cells, the vacuoles may take up most of the cell's space. Chloroplast. Now we come to plastids, and the plastids, as you all know, may be chloroplast, leucoplast. Chloroplast come under chromoplast, that is colored plastics. So chloro means the plastids that contain chlorophyll. They are obviously related to photosynthesis. As I showed, chlorophyll is associated with synthesis of food in plants, with the process of photosynthesis. It gives green color to the stem and leaves. It captures sunlight and uses that energy to produce food called glucose, carbohydrate. This is the structure, basic structure, to elaborate how the different cell organelles work in cohesion to carry out different functions of the cell. Thank you.